Hi, my name's Kip Bradford, and I'm here on behalf of ExpertVillage. In this clip, we're going to look at the different ways that we can test cabling to see if it is, one, been soldered up properly, and two, if it might have a problem in terms of troubleshooting. Here are the two most common ways to test cabling. You have, this is the simplest way, which is a device, and many companies make this type of a thing, which is a cable tester. You plug your XLR into this end, and then a series of lights will tell you if the pins have been soldered to the right connections, if you're not getting continuity through one of the conductors or more, and so forth. And it gives you the ability to use several different kinds of connectors. We have XLR, we have quarter inch, both non-balanced and balanced. We can test MIDI cables, we can test our RCA cables. It's just a very handy device. Now the multimeter has a readout here, and of course you can check voltages, both AC and DC. This one you can check temperatures of things and a whole lot of different things. Now there's, on a multimeter, you'll usually find up near the top here a little horseshoe shaped symbol, and that is a symbol for ohms. And ohms are what we measure in electronics to see how much resistance we have in the cable. So we would turn our knob to the ohms. So if you set the dial to the horseshoe shaped symbol, which is the symbol for ohms, and this can test the impedance of a cable. So if you just take the test probes and you put them together, we will get 0.000, which is infinity, which means we have a connection and we essentially have very little, if any, resistance. We'll always have some, but we're not measuring it here. So then if we get our XLR cable, we can take, and we know the center pin, and so I'll just insert one probe into the center pin, and then we take the other probe, and on the female or the male side, we can reach in here and touch the center pin, and we should get 0 ohms. And we do. So we know that the center to the center, or the number 2 pin, is properly connected. Now remember, these, the male and female, sit back to back. So if we go into the number 1, we'll have to go to the same side if we're holding them this way, and if we're holding them back to back, the opposite side, and we'll touch here, and we know that we have a proper connection. Now we're going to go ahead and do the other one. So this cable is good.